Today, I'm going to talk about Hera, the goddess queen, and the wife of Zeus, the king of the gods. Hera is one of the 12 Olympian gods, and the goddess of woman, marriage, family, and childbirth. She was also known as the Roman goddess Juno, and the month of June is named after her. Fun fact, June is the most popular month for marriages. Cow-eyed and white-armed are two of Hera's most famous epithets, which Homer commonly used to characterize her. She was also known as a virgin, since she was reported to wash every year in a spring to maintain her virginity. Hera, who wears golden sandals, is the queen of heaven and is always a virgin, as she bathes at a spring named Canithus in Argolis every year to reclaim her virginity. Hera possibly comes from the Greek word heros, meaning hero or warrior, and hora being period of time, or aitheo, meaning to be chosen, while her Roman counterpart name, Juno, is possibly related to an Indo-European root meaning young. She was eaten by her father at birth, much like each of her siblings except Zeus, and eventually disgorged to be born again. Cronos and Rhea are her parents. Hera was Zeus's sister and wife, and the family tree included Poseidon, Hades, Demeter, and Hestia. Hera had one lover, Zeus. Her own marriage was far from flawless, despite the fact that she was the goddess of marriage. Hera had to deal with Zeus's numerous affairs, which caused her to become enraged, envious, and vindictive. Ares, Hebe, Eileithyia, Hephaestus, and Eris are her offspring. Hera had no lovers other than Zeus. Did you know? Zeus, while being a fickle spouse, could not take anybody flirting with Hera. Exion was one of these mortals who wished to have romance with Hera, but instead had it with a cloud. He was imprisoned in Tartarus for betraying Zeus and chained on a spinning wheel of fire. She was commonly depicted as a beautiful woman wearing a crown and wielding a royal lotus-tipped scepter, sometimes accompanied by a lion, cuckoo, or hawk. She is a trustworthy, loyal, compassionate, and submissive woman to her master and her spouse. She is, on the other hand, a vivacious and resourceful wife, as well as argumentative, impatient, oppressive, and envious. The cow, the lion, the cuckoo, the peacock, and the panther were Hera's sacred animals. Hera's divine animals, the cow, is identified with her in part because of her incredible beauty, notably her gorgeous wide eyes and loving watchfulness over her followers. The peacock, on the other hand, signifies her wealth, beauty, and immorality. The lily, pomegranate, and lotus were Hera's sacred plants. Woman, marriage, childbirth, and family are Hera's four principal domains. Hera blessed and protected a woman's marriage, provided her with fertility, safeguarding her children, and supported her in reaching financial security. The goddess Juno was one of the most popular Roman gods, and her temple, Juno Monita, was built on the Capitoline Hill as part of the Capitoline Triad, which includes Jupiter, Juno, and Minerva. In Greek mythology, a Heraion is a temple dedicated to the goddess Hera. Fun fact, Hera and Zeus honeymooned on Samos for 300 years. Heracles, Greek mythology's most recognizable hero, was included in some of the most well-known legends concerning Hera. Ironically, Heracles' name means glory of Hera. Despite his name, Hera despised Heracles, which probably had more to do with Zeus than Heracles himself. When Zeus learned of Alcmene's pregnancy, he told all the gods that a child of Zeus would be born on this date, and that he would govern all those around him. Hera made Zeus swear an oath to this claim, and so began her hatred of Heracles. When that day arrived, she went to see Stellinus, Perseus's son, whose wife was expecting a child in 2 months. But, as the goddess of childbirth, she ensured that the birth took place on that particular day. She later went to Alcmene and postponed the birth of Heracles, ensuring that Zeus's vow would be kept and that the prophecy he made would apply to Eurystheus, Zeus's great-grandson, rather than Heracles. Hera sent two snakes into the boy's bedchamber to kill him while he was sleeping. But the next morning, Heracles was found joyfully waving around the two snakes he had strangled. When Heracles grew up and started his own family, Hera drove him insane, where he murdered said family. In order to redeem himself, he would have to complete his labors, which happened to be chosen by Hera and King Eurystheus. They believed that the 12 labors would ultimately kill Heracles, but they were mistaken. Heracles did die, but not through Hera's hands. He'd also become a permanent resident of Olympus at that point, so you might say Heracles had the last laugh. Hera is in the movie Heracles, 1997. Heracles' parents were played by Zeus and Hera. Juno is a well-known email hosting service. Hera may be seen in a wide range of pop culture items. She is well-known as her role as a villain in Rick Riordan's Percy Jackson books.